It's your boy Seth the Lawn Surgeon, and I have no idea what I'm doing today.
I know what I'm doing, I just don't, you know. Usually when I start a video, I have a direction I'm going in, and I'm like, you know, I'm gonna do this today, I'm gonna do this today, you know, this will be good to put on the channel. But today I just grabbed my camera, because if y'all haven't noticed, I've been trying to put out way more content, way more videos, so right now I'm averaging at least a video every other day. So in order for me to keep that up, I have to just make random videos. So today I'm only planning, because usually some people call me on Saturdays, planning to do two jobs. One job was a guy wanting to get some leaves out of his yard, and he wants me to cut it, so I'm gonna do that. And then another lady, she wants me to hedge some branches off one of this big pine bush or something, so I'm gonna do that. So that's all I'm doing today, you know, nice and easy, you know. But right now I'm on my way to the dump. I'm gonna drop some leaves off at the dump, and then I'm going to head on back to the house to get all my equipment, because all I got is leaves on the trailer right now. Hopefully not flying all over the place. But yeah, talk to you guys later. Okay, now we're on the way back to his house to get my equipment. I think I'm just gonna roll with the good old Gravely for mowing the yard vac, Craftsman. And the Echo, you know. I like using the Echo as a daily trimmer. I got the smallest Echo they have, which is, I believe it's the smallest. It's the smallest multi-tool trimmer they have, which is the Echo PAS 225. I actually have two of them. And I forgot to mention that during the summer. This summer, BJ actually hooked me up. He helped invest into the company. What he did was, I was like online, it was like the middle of the summer sometime. I was on Craigslist and this guy was selling a PAS 225. He says it's only about a year old. He had the motor head, the trimmer attachment, and it came with an edger attachment and another hedger, right? I have the articulating hedger, which is the kind that bends, you know, bends at the front. This is the small one, the straight one, which is much lighter. They're not much lighter. Both of them heavy as a mug, but anywho, the guy was selling it for $300. Now, mind you, the motor, actual motor part is set, 170. Like, this is brand new pricing. The actual motor part is 170. No, 180. The actual trimmer part attachment is $80. So just for the trimmer PAS and the trimmer head, that's what you're looking at. It goes 80, 260. You're looking at about 260, right? Just for that. Then I know that hedger is at least 150. I want to say it's 160, but I'll say it's 150. So now you're up to $410, and then you get the edger. You know, the edger is at least 100 and something, so I say that's 130. So that's about $550 worth of stuff for $300. And I'm like, man, that would be awesome, because then we would have a second trimmer. Well, a small trimmer that can use attachments. You know what I mean? I already have two trimmers. I got the Shindawa. And so BJ was like, I didn't have the money at the time. So BJ said, you know what? You know, how much did the guy selling it for? I said, $300. He said, how about I give it to you, give it back to me at the end of the month? I was like, word. So BJ gave me the $300. Went and bought the stuff, and it was a little sketchy at first, right? Because when I got there, mind you, my Echo PAS is a 2014. His was a 2015, and his looked way more rough than mine. It looked like he didn't have no trimmer rack, so he just put the trimmer in the back of his trailer, and the junk was just like drizzled and boom, rolling around while he was driving. I'm like, bro, like, how does my trimmer look way better than yours? You know, it was all scratched up, it was faded from the sun, the spark plug boot, it had like a rip in it, right? And I started using it, right? And I was using it and my elbow hit the motor and I got electrocuted. I was like, oh snap, like what in the world? Like it shocked me so hard that it cut off. And I'm like, what? And so I found out it had a scratch in the boot. so that if you get too close to it, it'll shock you. So I had to put some tape over it. That fixed that. It had a hole in the bubble, you know? So it's in rough condition. The only reason I bought it is because I've had my, like I said, I've had mine since 2014, and I know how good these Echoes are. A lot of people talk about steel. Steel is good. I feel like all trimmers that's commercial grade are good. You know what I mean? You can't say one is better than the other. They're all good. The thing is, how much do you really want to pay? If you want to pay an extra $100 just for the name steel, you could be my guest, but my Echo didn't work fantastically for me, you know? So I knew it was a good trimmer, good brand. So I got it and it's been great. You know, it runs a little rougher than mine because, you know, I clean out my mufflers and stuff like that when I get a chance. I don't think he's done that. I need to do that today. Anywho, that's how I got that trimmer. I know y'all saw it in that my lawn care setup. Like, when did he get that second trimmer? That's how I got it. I got it this summer. So, but anyway, that long-winded story leading to say, I like using the Echo. You know what I mean? I used to use the Shindawa on a daily basis because of the power. But when you get into cutting like, you know, 8 or 9 yards a day, that freaking Shindawa, that junk's heavy. You know what I mean? And it's 15 pounds, you know what I mean? So it just gets wearing out on your arms, whereas in the Echo is 10 pounds. So it's lighter, you know what I mean? And with the Echo, I don't even need the strap. If y'all notice with my Echo, I don't even have a strap on it because it's so light, you know what I mean? I don't know if it's, I'm a big guy, boom, boom, boom. Oh, BJ doesn't even use the strap either. But it's just light, you know what I mean? It's light. It does the job and it's awesome, you know what I mean? So I like using it. So, and plus I think my speed feed head on my Shindawa is messed up. So I'm gonna have to buy another one of those for that. But if you are looking to do a setup, right, what I would suggest to you is the setup that I had started with is freaking awesome. Like, if somebody asks me, which trimmer should I start with? Now, I'm not gonna tell you which brand, I'm gonna tell you which kind of trimmers to get, right? If you're starting off, the first trimmer I would get would be a commercial multi-tool. The reason I say this is, one, get commercial because when I first started off, I used to use Troy Bilt. I used to run through like one of those a year, you know what I mean? And this was back when I was only had like 5 or 7 yards, you know what I mean? I would wear them out because they're not meant to be, they're residential, they're not meant to be used that much. So I would wear it out. So if one thing that you would get that's commercial when you first start off your business is trimmers. Get a commercial multi-tool trimmer. The reason I say multi-tool is because when you're starting off, you can't afford to buy $200 and $400 trimmers. You know what I mean? You can't buy a freaking trimmer, a edger, a hedge trimmer, blah blah blah. You can't buy all that stuff. That's expensive. I would go out. I would get a multi-tool motor with the trimmer attachment and a hedger. That's all you need to start with. You don't really need an edger because you can edge with your trimmer until you can afford to get a trimmer attachment. But those are the two things you start off with, right? And you'll be straight. First couple years, you can use that for the first couple years. Then, got neighbors out here running, trying to work off that Thanksgiving turkey. But yeah, you know, it'll be good for a couple years, man. And then once you know, start collecting all the attachments, then you can go ahead and get you a straight trimmer. And that means not the multi-tool, like an actual trimmer. and go for the strongest one you can get, because the strong one, it kind of substitutes for a brush cutter. You get what I'm saying? Like a brush cutter. Well, let me back into the yard right quick. All right, I'm gonna finish this thought right quick because I think this is a good information. A brush cutter, right? A brush cutter, you know, I used to have a brush cutter with my Troy Bilt. And mind you, yes, it was a Troy Bilt brand, so it probably wasn't as strong. I haven't really ran into too many situations where I needed a brush cutter, really. You know what I mean? Because, like, especially if you got a chainsaw, you know what I mean? Like, if you're trying to clear out some brush and you don't have like a bush hog, or you don't want to drop your mower in there, the best thing to really do is to use your weed eater to knock down the lighter stuff and anything that's big. I just go back in there with my chainsaw, zoom, 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 you know, and knock it down, you know what I mean? Rather than getting that brush cutter attachment. You know what I'm saying? I'm all about using stuff, multi-purposing stuff, you know what I mean? So with that being said, you know, once you have your multi-tool trimmer with at least the trimmer head and your hedge trimmer attachment, I really say you don't really need an edger, or whatever. I just got an edger because, you know, it was part of that deal. But go ahead and get your actual straight trimmer, because what happens is straight trimmers, that's not the multi, because the multi-tool has that connection in the middle. A straight trimmer is stronger, you know what I mean? Why, even though the multi-trimmer is still strong because it's commercial grade, that straight trimmer is less likely to mess up or, you know, break your stuff at that connection, because it doesn't have a connection. Get the strongest one you can find, which I found at Shindawa 34 T344, which is 34.5 cc's. I think that's the strongest one on the market. I haven't seen anything stronger than that. I believe Echo's strongest one is a 28 cc. Not sure what Steel's strongest one is, but I'm pretty sure a 28 cc is gonna be wanging. It's gonna be knocking some stuff down. So I've had a lot of problems with my Shindawa. I'm not gonna blame it on the company Shindawa. I'm going to blame it on where I got it from. I don't think they had taken care of it, you know, as well as they should have. It might have been, you know, dusty or something and whatnot. But if I had to go, if I'm still setting up another crew, I'm going with all Echo stuff. I would probably get the straight shaft 28cc Echo. And then I already got my second multi-tool, so that would be my crew, you know what I mean? Like, one crew would have that 28cc Echo and a multi PAS, and then my other crew, probably me, would have the Shindawa and the other PAS. So hope that's good info. Like to drop a little jewels here and there. I'm about to go get my equipment loaded up. Yeah, we'll be right back. Thank you.